Good morning, children. Welcome to Chapter 4, Landforms, Andhra Pradesh, Part 5. In previous videos, we discussed about landforms, about Andhra Pradesh, and different landforms of Andhra Pradesh. Those are hilly regions, plateau region of Andhra Pradesh. Now, in this video, we are going to learn about plains of Andhra Pradesh. Plains. Plains are level lands with flat surfaces which have maximum height of 200 meters above the sea level. Plains are densely populated areas because of fertile soils, and those plains are highly productive. Means in plains, so much fertile lands will be there, fertile soils will be there. That's why those are very productive and so many people live. Densely populated means so many people live in plain areas. In Andhra Pradesh, the plains are situated in coastal districts. Already you know what are the coastal districts. There are 9 coastal districts in our Andhra Pradesh. Those are Srikakulam, Vijayanagaram, Visakhapatnam, East Godavari, West Godavari, Krishna, Guntur, Prakasam and Nellore. The plains are stretching from Srikakulam district in the north to Nellore district in the south. The plains are stretching from in our state towards north, from Srikakulam to towards south to Nellore district, these plains are situated. And these plains are also known as coastal plains. In our Andhra Pradesh, these coastal plains are called coastal plains. And plains are areas are important for agriculture because the alluvial soils are deposited as sediments. Here, alluvial soils are deposited as sediments. Sediments means matter that has been deposited by some natural process. That means this alluvial means this is one type of soil. Along with the rivers, along with the water, these alluvial soils are deposited as sediments. That means in the soil, those alluvial soils will be more. Because of that, those are very fertile and it is very important for agriculture. And they are deep and fertile, and the flatness facilitates the mechanization of crop cultivation. These plains are deep and those soils are very fertile and the area is flat. These all features facilitates the mechanization of crop cultivation. That means it is very good for crop cultivation. On the other hand, they support grasslands which provide fodder for livestock. That means remaining all area will be with full of grass. That means grasslands, those are called as grasslands. Grasslands provide food for the livestock, means for animals. Animals food. These grasslands provide food for those animals. The plains found in Guntur, Krishna and Godavari districts are famous for rich fertility and principal crops like paddy, sugarcane, chillies, turmeric, etc. The plains found in Guntur district, Krishna and East Godavari, West Godavari districts are very famous for rich fertility and principal crops. Principal crops means main crops. What are the main crops there? In those districts, paddy, sugarcane, chillies, turmeric, all. And in Guntur district, the uplands have clayey black soils, which are more suitable for cotton and chili crops. In some areas of Guntur district, there some uplands are there. In those uplands, the black soils are there. Black soils are very good for cultivation of cotton and chili crops. Cotton means patti, you know, from cotton seeds only the cotton cloth they will prepare. That all these cotton and chili crops will grow more in these black soils. The paddy monsoon crop is called as kharif and winter crop is called as rabi. In previous video, we discussed about the crop seasons, kharif, rabi, all. So, monsoon crop is called as kharif and winter crop is called as rabi. Now, delta. What is a delta? A low triangular area of alluvial deposits where a river divides before entering a large water body, that is sea or ocean, is called as delta. All the rivers, finally, they have to mix with seas or oceans. That means, those before entering into the sea or ocean, if these rivers, they will flow in small streams and finally it will enter into the sea or ocean. Before entering into that, it will make one delta, it is in the triangular shape. And in Andhra Pradesh, two main rivers of Godavari and Krishna form a very big plain in the form of delta. In our Andhra Pradesh, so many rivers are there, main rivers Godavari and Krishna. Before entering into the Bay of Bengal, those two rivers form some delta. Those are very fertile. That area, that plains are very fertile and it is very good for cultivation. The delta plains are treasure houses for food grains and are called rice granary of South India. These delta plains are treasure houses for what? Good grain, food grains. And those are called as rice granary of South India. In South India, these areas are very fertile and it is very good for cultivation of grains. In these plains, the underground water sources are very rich and can be found at a depth of only 15 to 25 feet. If we dig the earth from 15 feet onwards, we will get water. See, in a previous video, we discussed about plateau region. There, we have to dig in plateau region. We have to dig the earth to 200-250. Then only we will get water in the plateau region. But why? Because that is drought-prone area. There, the rainfall is very low. But here, these are plains. Here, so much water resources are there. That's why if we dig the earth from 15 to 25 feet, we will get underground water. Now lakes. What is a lake? A lake is a large water body within a body of land. That means we can say a large pond is called as a lake. So in our coastal plains, there are two main lakes are there. Those are Kolleru Lake and Pulikat Lake. Kolleru Lake is a freshwater lake and it is located in West Godavari district. Pulikat Lake, it is a saltwater lake and it is located in Nellore district. You have to keep in your mind, Kolleru Lake is a freshwater lake and it is in West Godavari district. Pulikat Lake is a saltwater lake and it is in Nellore district. See, this is the Andhra Pradesh map. Here, these are all from Srikakulam north to Nellore south. These districts are called as coastal districts. In these all districts, these coastal plains are there. Okay. And here, see, this is Godavari, River Godavari, and this is River Krishna. These two rivers, they originated from Western Ghats. Western Ghats means in previous video, we discussed about Western Ghats. From Arabian Sea to after Arabian Sea, there some ghats, some hill ranges are there. Those are called as Western Ghats. Like this towards east also, Bay of Bengal side, there some eastern ghats are there. So like that, from the Western Ghats, these Krishna and Godavari originated. That means they started from there and they flow like this and they will finally enter into the Bay of Bengal. Before entering into the Bay of Bengal, see, just like small streams like that, and this river will form a delta. This sea, this all area, this is called as delta. Like this for Krishna River also, here see, it will enter into the Bay of Bengal like this, and here also it formed a delta. These are called as delta plains. Along with this river water, so much alluvial soil, so many fertile soils, good soils will be collected here, and those are very fertile and so much water also will be there in those areas, very good for cultivation. Next, Kolleru Lake. Kolleru Lake is a freshwater lake and it is located in West Godavari district. See, this is Kolleru Lake. Here it is Kolleru Lake. Like that Pulikat Lake, it is in Nellore district. Here it is a saltwater lake. Like this, along the with this Godavari and Krishna, so many rivers are there. See here, Vamsadhara, Nagavali, Sarada, so many rivers are there. Those also flow through our state, Andhra Pradesh. See, this is the picture of east coastal plains. Coastal plains, see, from north Srikakulam to south Nellore, these are green color, these are all called as plains. And see here, this is river Godavari and Krishna. Before entering into the sea, they form the delta, triangular shape. Now, diversity in lifestyles. We find these all different landforms in different parts of Andhra Pradesh. Different landforms, what? Hills or mountains, plateaus, plains, all. These all are there in our Andhra Pradesh. In different parts of Andhra Pradesh. And we also find diverse situations, physical and climatic features, economic activities, in our state Andhra Pradesh. Diverse situations, physical and climatic features also. In hilly regions, the climatic conditions will be different. In plains, one type of climate. In plateaus, another type of climate. So different physical and climatic features will be there, and different situations will be there, and depending upon that, economic activities also. If you take in hilly regions, there what are the economic activities, how the people can earn their living? They have to grow the kitchen garden, and they have to follow the podu cultivation, and that also not sufficient for them. That's why they will collect the forest produce. Some types of products they will collect from the forest, and they will sell and they will earn their living. What are the forest products? Honey and tamarind and wild roots and wild fruits, vegetables, all they will collect, and soap nets, all they will collect and they will sell in the market, and they will earn the money. If you take in plains, there are so many fertile lands, so fertile soils will be there. That's why crops also grown very good, and they will get so much production. That's why they set up so many agro-based industries also there. That's why so many people live in plain areas. In plateau region, that cultivation is not good. Why? Because of that scanty rainfall. That's why they have to depend on other occupations like farms and orchards, like that they have to grow. Animal rearing, like that they will earn their living. And coal butties, all they will do, and they will earn their living. Now, diversity in landforms also impacts the flora and fauna of a region, occupation and food patterns. Depending upon the landforms, the flora and fauna, that means plants, animals, are grown on the basis of the landform. So, basing on that, the occupation of the people also will be different, and food patterns also will be different from different landforms. On the basis of landforms, these will be different. Okay, children, I think all of you understand. So, that's all. This lesson completed, fourth lesson completed. Now, a small assignment for you. In Andhra Pradesh, the two main rivers are dash and dash. Kolleru Lake is a dash water lake. Pulikat Lake is in dash district. In plain area of Andhra Pradesh, the dash soils are deposited as sediments. In Guntur district, the uplands have clayey dash soils, which are more suitable for cotton and chili crops. Thank you.